Equilibrium Income Determination, Savings and Investment Approach. Savings and investment are measured along the y-axis and national income along the x-axis. S is the savings curve. It is governed by savings function. It slopes upwards. It is a positive function of income. With increase in income, people plan to save more. I is the investment curve. It is parallel to x-axis. It is autonomous in nature. It does not depend on income. It simply tells us that the business community has planned to invest a fixed amount, that is OA1 amount, whatever be the income. They intersect at point F1. This is the equilibrium point where the economy is in equilibrium. Y1 is the equilibrium level of income. This occurs when planned savings is equal to planned investment. Take income Y0. Let it be the prevailing income. It is less than the equilibrium level of income. Investment is F0, but savings is T0. Investment is greater than savings. It means aggregate demand is greater than aggregate supply. Business community will use the existing inventories to meet the demand. It in turn leads to a reduction in stock. In order to arrest further depletion, they produce more. Consequently, output, income, and employment will increase. The economy will move towards equilibrium. Take any income to the right of Y1. Let it be Y2. It is greater than the equilibrium level of income. Savings is T2, but investment is F2. Investment is less than savings. It means aggregate demand is less than aggregate supply. Business community is unable to exhaust its entire stock. In turn, it leads to accumulation of undesired stock. In order to arrest further growth of stock, they produce less. Consequently, output, income, and employment will decrease. The economy will move towards the equilibrium level of income. At last, the economy will reach the point F1 and be in equilibrium. Y1 equilibrium will be established.